Hey, horse people! I think I did a video on this a while ago. I can't remember. Somebody sent me this, but either I wanted to do a video and I didn't, or I did a video and I forgot. But I get a lot of questions about should I own a stallion, or I got a stallion and I don't know whether I should geld it. Look, let me be clear. Stallions are destined to a miserable life and domestication. They're going to break out. They're going to breed mares. They have one thing on their mind, and they end up hurting people, and they end up tearing up things because they have to get to the mares. It's just in their drive. If you have a stallion, you need to geld him. And I know people are going to be like, I mean, there's so many wild horses dying. There's so many backyard breeders. There's so many people breeding. I'm telling you, we don't need any more horses out there. If you have a stallion, and I don't, you know, and I know that the number one question is, oh, he's so beautiful, and I want to have a little baby so I can raise him. Oh, geez. Just get over yourself. You don't need to have a baby and raise it. There's plenty of babies that are orphaned that need homes. If you want a baby, go get a baby. But if I have the stallion, it'll be his, and I'll feel like I'm part of it because I bred it, and I'm so special. Oh, geez. Just geld your stallions, people. There's just... It's a miserable life. You can't let them out with mares. You can't let them out with geldings. They fight. They're aggressive. You got to keep them caged up. Then you keep them caged up, and you create all these negative behaviors. They end up striking and rearing, and I'm going to show you some of this in here. That's all caused by humans locking up horses. Natural stallions don't do that, and there's no geldings in the wild. So a natural stallion gets out there. He's working. He's breeding. He's protecting his herd. He's moving them. He is busy. He's got a job, and he works his butt off, and that's why he's only a head stallion for probably a year or two before he gets worn out and somebody, a youngster, comes around and takes him out. So just geld your stallions. There's just no reason to have them. They're just destined to a horrible life. So in this video here, this horse just smelt where a mare was at. He's doing a flema response. You lift the nose up. It opens up his smelling glands, and he can get in more sensitive. Horses will do that sometimes if they smell a skunk, if they get a really strong odor or something. They'll do that because they really want to get something deep and figure out. So this is a – now, geldings will do this. This isn't – I've even seen mares do it. This isn't just stallions. But – sorry, I still got my cold. I'm going to go in here to this lady working this horse here. Now, somebody was talking about, I don't know if I read in the comment or the person that sent it to me, about cross ties and using chains and all that crap. Look, when you start hurting a stallion, that doesn't help. I'm not saying this method is horrible. I'm not saying it's great. I'm just going to tell you some things that, I mean, this is the horse's cage. He's stalled up. They have a piece of rope here for him to chew on. I don't think you ought to have a piece of rope for a horse to chew on, because then you'll teach cribbing. And then if the rope goes away or something, then the horse will start doing it to wood or anything else. So I'm not a fan. If you're having to tie something to occupy your horse, that's a clue your horse is locked up too much. Because horses that are kept in pasture do not crib. Now I know somebody's going to come here, well, I got a horse that's in pasture and it cribs. It cribs because it was locked up in a stall and it was caged and it learned that habit, and now it's continued it when you let it out. And, you know, I mean, for cribbing, you can try grazing muzzle. I don't like the cribbing collars that jabs into the throat, but whatever. I mean, you just can't, sometimes you can't fix stupid when horses ruin, humans ruin horses all the time, and then they want some easy fix. The fix is, don't do the stupid stuff that ruins them. Don't lock them up so they become a cribber. Don't give them a rope to chew on so they become a cribber. Don't do things that keep them so bored and locked up all the time that they have to, their mind goes crazy and they end up cribbing. Don't do stupid things like that. Then you don't have to worry about fixing it. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Everybody wants to come to me for a pound of cure. Why don't you try doing an ounce of prevention and not getting it that way? Well, Rick, I rescue and it's not my fault. I don't want to hear it. You know, don't get me started on rescues. I'm so fed up with rescues. Anyway, so let's look at this horse. I'm going to turn the sound up here. Now, I think this woman here is doing this on purpose for the video. There's an old saying in a horse world that that boy's so stupid he'd brush a horse against the grain. And I mean, when you brush a horse, it's common sense to go with the grain on the fur. You don't go against the grain. Doesn't feel good. If you comb your hair, you don't usually go against the grain. You comb your hair down. I mean, that's just common sense to me. If you brush a horse, you brush with the grain of the hair. You'll notice this lady is going back and forth with this brush in an irritating manner, which is why I think she wants to cause this to make her point. But in a minute, when a horse stops this, you'll notice she's only brushing with the grain, and she's not doing this back and forth, aggressive, irritating. Okay, so what this horse stomping and doing that, horses will stomp to show their strength to impress another stallion. Is this good? Do you want to correct this? Look, you've got a horse locked up in a stall. She's obviously scared of the horse because she's got a rep through here. She's standing away from the horse. She's letting the horse do what it wants. She's irritating the horse to make it do this. And then we wonder why the horse does it. And why he'll progress to more aggressive things. Now, again, I think she's doing it on purpose to make her point, but I could be wrong. I'm just watching the You got a horse acting like this? That's a clue. This isn't a happy horse. This isn't a horse that is handled or has enough outside time. This is a horse that's frustrated, that's irritated, that has mindless been caged, is acting out. He's doing things that the humans caused because of the way they kept or treated him. That's why this horse is doing this. You will not see this in a wild stallion unless he's challenging another stallion or to impress a mare. So, do you want to encourage this? No. If a horse is doing this, you might want to change what you're doing. If you do the same thing, the horse is going to do the same thing. Notice how she's standing back here. Horse knows that she's afraid of him. No, Rick, she's just protecting herself. She's being good. I'm telling you, a horse knows when you're running around, jumping and hiding and pulling on a rope and reaching around a corner and reach. The horse knows you're scared of him. He knows you don't trust him. I'm not saying she should trust him. I'm just saying she's continuing to promote negative behavior in the stallion. Now notice she's going with the grain. Horse likes it. So she says down here in a comment, whoever put this video up. The horse calmed down and is enjoying. Well, he's enjoying it because you're not irritating him going back and forth like you were before. Now, again, I call that critical eye. Most people will miss that. They wouldn't have caught that. But you need to understand when a horse is doing something, you have to look at what the human is doing to cause that. A horse is a reflection of the person handling it. So she gives it a carrot. I'm not sure that's a great thing. I mean, if you're having to give carrots to let your horse gro to groom your horse. Again, that's a clue. You're doing something wrong. You shouldn't have to give carrots. Notice her standing back, very fearful, ready to bail, ready to get away. Probably smart.
No, I wasn't done yet.
but she's torquing that foot, probably causing pain. When you pick a horse's hoof up, you need to have it hang naturally. This horse, when you twist it out, it's like putting an elbow lock or a twist lock on a human arm. It hurts. It torques this elbow in this joint. It's torquing this joint and that joint and that joint because you're pulling to the outside. You never want to pull. That's why farriers, when they get, I see them with old horses, you'll see them standing way on the outside, ripping at a horse's side and wondering why the horse is fighting them. I'm like, dude, man, why don't you move in next to the horse? I don't want to get hurt. I don't know this horse. All right. Farriers always got excuses to torque on horse's feet. That's why I like using the stand. My horse's feet, I can move the stand to where it's comfortable for the horse. I don't have to be scared and tweaking. A stallion doesn't want his mane brushed. He doesn't care about being groomed. A stallion wants to be out with mares breeding and have a herd. He's a herd animal. Humans want to make it think that I'm loving a horse and I'm giving it. The old saying, good horse care is more than good hay and fine stables. Because just because you give a horse good hay and you have a nice stable does not mean you're giving a horse good care. A lot of times it actually means the opposite. Because you think you are and you don't realize how much a horse needs a herd and his other animals. I thought I did this video before. This is normal stallion behavior. There's a lot of things going on here. Hopefully you got something out of it. Geld your stallions. There's no reason for him. It'll have a better life. He'll probably still act like a stallion for, you know, a few months, maybe 6 months, 3 months, maybe a year. But you know what? Cut those boys off and let him get out there and be a horse and he can hang out. Not worry about getting other horses pregnant. Not worry about him tearing down fences and breaking out. Not worrying about having to keeping him locked up. Not building up his frustration and anger and giving him a miserable life locked up in a stall. I think in one video here they let him out to go play with other horses. And they think this is great. I mean, I don't know how often this horse gets out. But you know what I do know? It's not enough. I guarantee you it's not enough. Somebody's going to come here. I know this. They love their horses. They're always BS. Horses want to be out running free. They want to be doing this, mentally stimulating their mind, doing something besides sitting in a stall waiting for you to give them a carrot or brush them. That's not what horses want to do. Geld your stallions, people. Pulling it there.